Hey guys, it's Alicia and welcome back to my channel and welcome to a weekend vlog. I thought that it's been a while since I've done any kind of vlog, and I thought that it would be fun to take you along with me this weekend. It is Friday around noon, and I've got a couple things to do. I am going to be putting my pillows, my throw pillows, into storage, so I need to get some storage bins. Dude Perfect came out with a smoothie back in March, and it's only around till May, so my brother and I are gonna go and try it out. So we're gonna head out in just a little bit, hit Smoothie King, and go and get some bins for my pillows. Gotta pick up a little bit about around my room, and then I will be filming a video. I got a new organizer. I don't know if you can see it down there in front of my bed. It's technically a shoe organizer, but you know, that's one thing about me is I will literally take anything that can be used for book storage and I will turn it into book storage. So I am going to be filming a video reorganizing that. So I'm going to be doing that as well. And then tomorrow, I'm super excited. I took the day off work and my cousin is getting married, and tomorrow she is doing a wedding dress shopping day with all the girl cousins and her bridesmaids and the family and the aunts, and it's gonna be a huge group of people. So she's doing that tomorrow. We're gonna be driving to Milwaukee. And then Sunday, she's also doing another wedding dress appointment somewhere else. And I haven't 100% decided if I'm going to that. I probably will. I think my mom and sister are, so I'll probably go with that, with them for that. So, super fun weekend, super full, but I wanted to show you guys the books that I'm planning on reading this weekend. That is the goal, so let me show you. So, as of now, I only have one book on my, like, for sure have to read this weekend, and that is Betrothal or Breakaway by Leah Bruner. This is book 3 in the DC Eagle series about Ford Remington, but his nickname is Remy, and Amber. And it is a marriage of convenience, hockey romance. It is clean, fade to black. She is starting to say low spice, but there are no open door scenes, so it's still closed door, but probably more like PG-13 rating. So I'm very excited about that. Ford is my all-time favorite DC Eagle, so I'm very excited for his story. I have been waiting for it. So I have been sick the last couple weeks, and it's just been a crazy, crazy time. So this is the first time that I'm actually have been able to read it. So that is the main priority on my list this weekend. And then we'll just kind of see where the wind takes us, and we will just go with it. So I'm gonna pick up my room a bit, and then we will see what's next. Okay, bookshelf reorganization video has been filmed. It's a little bit of a mess. There's a lot of empty shelves. It's very weird. But now I'm just gonna kind of pick up the remaining pieces. I have a couple books that I need to take upstairs, clean up my room a little bit, and then I think my brother and I will be getting ready to head out. So yeah, I'll catch you guys in just a little bit. I'm out with Austin. We're running some errands, but we did just get the Dude Perfect smoothies from Smoothie King. What do you think about yours?
I like it. I think it's nice and sweet. Had a lot of flavor. I said after my first sip, I said they should be on the menu permanently.
Agreed. I get mine without protein powder because I don't like protein powder. I don't like the flavor. But yeah, it was really good. Really summery. I am intrigued to see if they put it or have something similar to it on the menu after this is over. But we got fancy cups, mm-hmm, and we're excited. So yeah, off to our next errand. It is about 5:30. Got back to the house a little bit ago, put my pillows in the organizer, put those upstairs, and I am finally sitting down to start Betrothal or Breakaway. Super excited, and I will I'll probably be reading for a little bit, and then I'm gonna be helping my mom get ready for dinner. We're having fried chicken and mashed potatoes, and I'm so excited. But I am gonna jump into this and read for a bit. Hello? 159 pages into Betrothal or Breakaway. We had dinner, we had fried chicken and potatoes and salad. It was very good. But cleaned up from dinner and then got to read for a bit. And as always, Leah is just blowing it out of the park. It's so cute. It is a marriage of convenience story, which is my bread and butter. But she has a heart condition that was amplified when she gave birth, and they get married so that she's on his insurance so that she doesn't have to stress about finances. They are best friends, have been since second grade. And one thing I absolutely love so much is that they feel like best friends. Like, there's been a couple flashbacks to when they were younger, but like, they just know each other. They know each other's tells and like silent communication, and it just, they feel like best friends. You know, that has always been my biggest conundrum issue with opposite sex best friends to more stories where it's a guy and a girl, is that they never feel like best friends because they never really know each other. And this just feels different. Like, they actually feel like best friends. And Ford has autism, and it's just been really interesting. I don't feel like we have a whole lot of books with like such a, like, she knows he has autism and he talks about having autism. And I just think that it's being done really well. I'm really enjoying it. I do unfortunately have to get ready for bed, but I just, I want to read it. I just want to finish it. It's so good. I'm loving it. Which I had a feeling I would, let's be real. I'm also loving the fact that Amber is such a soft, feminine character. I was really worried when I found out that she was gonna have a baby, because this it's not spoiling anything. You know that she has a baby. She's 3 months old. I was really worried that she was going to be very hard, just like a hard female character. You know, she went to the school of hard knocks, and you know, her ex-fiance leaves her when he finds out she's pregnant. So I just, most of these things, normally authors write the female characters to just be very harsh, like men hating, very independent, I can do it myself type of people. And Amber is just not that at all. She is still very independent. She doesn't want to like take everything from Ford, even though they're best friends, but she's just a soft, feminine, loving character who loves her baby. She's a great mother, but she also lets other people love her baby. You know, I don't know if I'm explaining that very well, but these are the feelings. I'm loving just her and him and them together and the family and the team aspect, and it's just a great time, and I'm so, so loving it. So I'm gonna go ahead and get into my jammies, get ready for bed. I was gonna have some ice cream, but it is kind of late and I don't think I should, unfortunately. So I think I'm just gonna go ahead and get ready for bed and then maybe read a couple more chapters before I hit the hay, because tomorrow's gonna be a pretty long day with my cousin's wedding dress day. I'm so excited. I'm not sure who's driving, so I don't know if I'll be able to get any reading done, but I will take it with me just in case, and I will catch you guys in just a bit. Well, it's gonna be a while for me, but I'll see you guys in a second.
We're doing a weekend vlog.
Okay. Hey guys, bit chat.
I was in my other vlog.
Q-K-8. Ate it up.
I like the M high.
Thank you.
Nice. Is it my turn for a fit check?
Sure, your turn for the fit check. Okay.
Hey guys, fit check.
Hold on, I gotta turn you your backlit so you're.
Nope.
There we go. I can edit that part out. Killed it.
See, those curls are not.
No.
With my dog. Speak. Okay, never mind.
Good morning, happy Saturday. We are getting ready to leave to go to my drive up to my cousin's wedding dress shopping day. My sister is driving. Ow! We got her to drive. I'm so excited because I did not want to drive. But I think I'm going to bring Betrothal or Breakaway so that I could potentially read in the car. We'll see. I might not. But I will have the option. So, yeah. I will talk to you guys in just a bit. Hello, it's Saturday evening. We got back from Milwaukee around 7:30-ish maybe before 7. My sister and I took the dog to go get ice cream on the lake, and driving home I was like, no, I should have got footage of us having ice cream. We took the dog with us. It was a lot of fun, but I completely spaced. But we did that, and I just got home and folded some clean laundry. Look at me being efficient. But I was gonna read because I'm itching to get back into the DC Eagles world. But my mom really wants to watch a couple episodes of All Creatures Great and Small. We got the season 4 DVDs from my library, so she's been itching to watch them all week. So I think we're gonna sit down and maybe watch an episode or two. But my goal is to hopefully read a couple chapters of Betrothal or Breakaway before I go to bed tonight, and then definitely finish it tomorrow. So we'll see. But that's the check-in. My cousin was beautiful. She tried on a bunch of different wedding dresses, found some things that she knows she likes now so she can look for in the future. She didn't say yes yet, but she definitely found some things that she's excited for. So she looked beautiful. We had a wonderful time. It's a lot of fun. Huge group of us, and it was great. But yeah, I am gonna go watch a couple episodes of All Creatures Great and Small with my mama, and then I'll check in with you guys in a little bit. Hello and happy Sunday. It is a little after 2. We just got back from church and lunch, and I think I'm gonna go outside for a couple hours and enjoy the beautiful weather that we're having and read some more of Betrothal or Breakaway. I'm so excited. We do have to leave around 4 to head to my cousin's second wedding dress appointment. I'm super excited about it. So I think my mom and I are the only ones going. I don't think my sister's gonna go, but I think my mom is driving. So if I don't finish Betrothal or Breakaway before we leave, I will take it with me and hopefully read a little bit in the car, potentially. Recently, I've been getting kind of motion sick, so we'll see. But yeah, I'm excited. So it is a stunning day outside. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and head out there and read for a little bit. I just finished Betrothal or Breakaway. It was so good. I have read all three, well, technically three and a half, because there is a novella connected to the series, and I've read all of them, and they all just feel so different. Desire Defense was so good, but Betrothal or Breakaway, one, Ford Remington has been my favorite character from the beginning, and it was so great to finally have his happily ever after. And just this one just felt so different. Like, it was still light and fun and fluffy and a cute romance, very cute, but it just felt like more than that. It just felt deep and homey and real, and I just loved seeing them interact with each other and just the friendship, because you could 100% tell that it was a friendship first. And then as she's falling in love with him, because he's loved her forever, but like didn't say anything, didn't ruin their friendship in that like weird way where someone's like pining after someone and it kind of ruins their friendship. It wasn't like that at all. It was just sweet, and their love was adorable, and Nella was so cute. But it was really sweet. And then just seeing the team interactions, as always, the DC Eagles are one of my favorite teams, and just the found family and the family aspects and just all the things, really. It was beautiful. I loved it. I think I'm gonna give it a 5-star just because it made me happy, and it was so just sweet. Like, there's a feeling, but I don't know how to describe it. Like, it really was just so heartwarming and so sweet, and just made me feel full and just happy. And I loved it, and I'm gonna write my full review, and that will be up on Goodreads, where I'll probably gush and swoon and do all my things that I normally do. But yes, I loved Ford, and I loved Amber, and so great. And I can't wait for Bruce's story. He is, I think, the last one getting his story, so I'm so excited. But yes, I absolutely love this book. I am bummed it took me pretty much the whole weekend. I was hoping to read at least two books this weekend, but that's okay. We had a very full, very fun weekend, and I'm gonna actually go ahead and end the vlog here, because we do need to head out and go to my cousin's wedding dress and shopping night, and I just don't want to have to worry about forgetting an outro. So I will see you guys next time. I hope you had a wonderful time following me along a little bit this weekend as I read Betrothal or Breakaway and absolutely loved it. And seriously, if you haven't read the DC Eagle series, please do. Please note, it is not Christian fiction. They are Fade to Black closed door with mild language. This one definitely had more talk of sex and higher innuendo just because they are married and yeah, it's brought up. So if that's not your thing, maybe pass on the series. But it is a great, clean hockey romance series. I absolutely love it. So just wanted to give that little bit as well. But I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget you can check out my blog at fortheloveofchristianfiction.blogspot.com. You can also check out my Instagram at fortheloveofchristianfiction, and all my other links are in the description box below. I think that's it. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!